Glory, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord. The Lord is good, amen. This is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Bethlehem, South Africa. I'm here this day again with the word of life to encourage you and to motivate you. You know, it's my usual practice. I won't stop doing this as long as I live. And as long as you like to listen, I am willing to talk according as God is leading me. So today, I'm going to talk to you about the purpose of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ to this world. Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. If you look at my statuses, either on Facebook or on WhatsApp and on many of my social networking media, one of the statuses that I use most of the time is born to raise hell. In actual fact, Jesus Christ was born to destroy the works of the devil. In the book of 1 John chapter 3 verse 8, the Bible talks about the devil, that the devil sinned from the beginning. But for this purpose, the Son of Man, which is Jesus, was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. In the book of Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14 and 15, the Bible talks about those who are all their lifetime are subject to the fear of death, that Jesus Christ came to deliver us from that fear of death. In Colossians chapter 2 verse 15, the Bible says that Jesus Christ defeated principalities and power. He made an open show of them. Hallelujah. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 6, the Bible says, we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world that is coming to naught. The wisdom of the devil is coming to naught. Hallelujah. Now, Jesus Christ was born to destroy the works of the devil. Acts chapter 10 verse 38 says, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. He went about doing good, healing all those who are oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. So Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. He came to heal. Remember in the book of Isaiah chapter 60, if you read from verse 1, Jesus was, it's talking about Jesus. Hallelujah. Because in Luke chapter 4, Jesus began to quote it. He said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because he has anointed me to bind up the brokenhearted. He has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. He has anointed me to open the blind eye. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ was anointed to destroy the works of the devil. Hallelujah. That is why he came to this world. He came to deliver you, no matter what you are going through. Jesus Christ came to deliver you from problem. Jesus Christ came to deliver you from sin. Jesus Christ came to deliver you from every situation that is making you to pain. Jesus Christ came to set you free. Hallelujah. The devil have no reason to bind you. The devil have no power to continue to oppress you. Whatever is oppressing you is trespassing. And in the name of Jesus, I decree, by the power of the name of Jesus, that that thing be broken out of your life. In the name of Jesus. You see, one thing about Jesus, he came and he did this assignment. And after 33 years of his sojourn on earth, he left this world. But when he was leaving the world, this is what he said to the disciples. And you know, those disciples he talked to, they are gone now. We are the disciples. We, the Christians of today, who are alive, those of us who are alive today, who believe in Christ, we are the disciples of Jesus. So we are the ones to whom Jesus said this word. When he rose up from the dead, he came to the disciples and said to them, as my Father have sent me, even so send I you. Hallelujah. Jesus is saying, even as my Father have sent me to destroy the works of the devil, I am sending you, go and destroy the works of the devil. Hallelujah. No matter who you are, he's not just talking to preachers or prophets or pastors or evangelists or apostles. He's talking to the disciples. Hallelujah. Of which I believe you are one. You are one because you love Jesus. I know you love Jesus. Because if you don't love Jesus, I'm sure you will not be listening to this. You are listening to this because you love God. Hallelujah. And so because you love God, you are a disciple. So God is saying, Jesus is saying, as my Father have sent me, I am sending you. Go and destroy the works of the devil. Go and heal the sick. Go and raise the dead. Go and preach the gospel to every creature. Hallelujah. You know that when he woke, when he rose up from the dead, and when he was going in the book of Mark chapter 16, when you read from verse 15, he now said to them, he said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. And this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devils. In my name, they will speak with new tongues. Hallelujah. They will drink deadly things, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay their hands on the sick and they shall recover. Hallelujah. That is the commission that God gave us. God has sent you to go and help somebody. God has sent you to go and bring joy to somebody's life. God has sent you to go and heal somebody. God has sent you to go and give something good to somebody. He has sent you to go and destroy the works of the devil. He has sent you to go and work for him. And that work you are doing for him is what we call ministry. Because that's the assignment. The assignment that God gave you is your ministry. Hallelujah. Whatever you are doing, whatever work you are doing, God expects it that you do that work in a way that you are going to bless somebody. You should do that work in a way that you are going to bring joy to the life of another person. You should do whatever job you are doing to add value to your environment, to add value to humanity. That is why God has given you the power and has given you the life so that you can add joy to other people. Hallelujah. So God has also called you, just as he called Jesus to destroy the works of the devil. You should go now and destroy the works of the devil. And this is the reason why I used to put it on my status. I say, I am born to raise hell. Hallelujah. Because Jesus himself was manifested that he might raise hell. To raise means to destroy. Hallelujah. I am born to destroy the kingdom of the devil. And that is why I send this message every morning. I send this message every morning to people so that I can destroy the works of the devil in people's lives. I do this ministry in order to do what Jesus has done, to heal the sick, to raise the dead, to preach good news to the poor. Hallelujah. Go and do likewise. God is sending you this day to go and help somebody because he has called us to do greater works than he did. And I hope you will cooperate with him. I hope you will team up with Jesus to do greater works than he did. I hope you will team up with Jesus to heal the sick. I hope you will team up with Jesus to preach to somebody today. I hope you will team up with Jesus to do something good for somebody today. Hallelujah. If you will do that, I believe God will bless you. Let me end up with prayer. Father, I pray for power to do your will. For this one that is hearing me, receive power to do the will of God. Receive power to move forward. Receive power to be a blessing to your generation. In the name of Jesus, it is done. Hallelujah. Amen. Once again, this is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ. I brought you this message to encourage you, and I believe you are encouraged. If this has blessed you, pass it to other people. And if you got this message by any means, and you want me to begin to send it to you, just save my number, and it is +27 7403 02 381. If you are on WhatsApp, then I will WhatsApp it to you every day. If you have iPad and you have iTunes stores, just go to the iTunes stores, type my name, and you are going to receive my messages. My messages are on iTunes, and you can, you know, listen to more messages on your iPad, through your iTunes. Thank you so much for listening. This is Joseph Adenuga once again saying thank you for listening. As I sign out, I say to your life, you are blessed. Keep the blessing.